There is a form Sokol and Bond. Always there is a strong tendency that it requires one electron. Therefore, what is going to happen is, whatever it takes this electron, here whatever you said is correct. For simplicity purposes only, I have taken here to form that one. But whatever you said is correct, it will attract, what is the energy required to attract only 0.01 or 0.05, that depends on silicon or germanium. Forms a covalent bond, okay, forms a covalent bond, then there is a hole will be created from the silicon. That's whatever, that is correct. For without explaining that all these things, simply I have taken it as a hole. It's clear? Next. There are some important constants or requirement formula are there, standard values are there that are required for doing problems. I'll give those things. Okay. Like, before going to see that one, kinetic energy is equals to half mv square. V is velocity. It's called speed, drift speed. Potential energy is equals to Q into V. This V is velocity, this V is potential difference. Q, charge, either Q or E. Sometimes we'll represent it as E, sometimes Q, but both are same always. Either Q or E. Instead of Q, you can write it as E. There is no problem. Okay. Now kinetic energy is equals to potential energy, therefore half mv square equals to ev. If you want v, 2ev by m. There is a one more formula for the problems. All these formulas are important for problems. Velocity v equals to 2ev by m. E, charge of electron, mass of electron, potential difference. Capital V is potential difference, small v is velocity. Now, mass of an electron, 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg. Charge of electron, QRE, 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. Now, another thing is, some of the times, the values, all these values they will give in the problem itself. Sometimes they may not give. In that case, these things are required. But 99% of the problems, they will give the data. The constants data will be given. But rare cases, they may not give. For that purpose, you have to remember, try to remember these things. It's not compulsory. Most of the things they will give. If not, means we require. Next one is, one electron volt I gave. Next, intrinsic concentration, Ni. N is concentration, electron concentration. I means intrinsic concentration, so total concentration. Ni equals to 10 power 10 centimeter cube. Per centimeter cube, if it is a silicon. Intrinsic concentration equals to 2.5 into 10 power 13 per centimeter cube if it is a germanium. All these things are at 300 degree Kelvin. At 300 degree Kelvin. Next formula is V equals to drift speed equals to mu into E. There is a one more formula. V equals to mu into E. Mu is mobility, E is applied electric field, V is velocity or speed, drift speed. The next formula is Eg is equals to 1.21 minus 3.6 into 10 power minus 4 T if it is a silicon. 0.785 minus 2.26, 2.2 into 10 power minus T if it is a germanium. This is called forbidden energy gap. Forbidden energy gap depends on temperature T. Depends on temperature T. At T equals to 0 degree Kelvin, Eg equals to 1.21, Eg equals to 0.785, if it is a silicon, if it is a germanium. At 300 degree Kelvin, at does nothing but at room temperature, 27 degree centigrade, the Eg value equals to 1.1 electron volt if it is a silicon, Eg equals to 0.72 electron volt if it is a germanium. If some other temperature, you have to use that formula. Next. Next, law of electrical neutrality. Law of electrical neutrality. Total positive charge is equals to total negative charge. Then we can say it's electrical neutral. What is meaning of electrical neutrality? Total positive charge is equals to total negative charge. Now what are the positive charge? Holes here, electrons, plus here ions, positive ions, here negative ions. So positive ions plus holes is equals to negative ions plus electrons. That we are writing it as positive charge holes P, electrons N plus. Positive charge, which ions are having positive charge? The ions which donated one electron. Donated one electron means phosphorus, arsenic. What are those impurities are called? ND, donor impurities. These are called donor impurities. This is called hole concentration. Holes are having positive charge, donor impurities are having negative charge. This is electron concentration. And an atom becomes ion, negative ion, by absorbing one electron. That is acceptor impurities. Boron, aluminum, gallium, they are acceptor impurities. Acceptor impurities. It's clear? Now, the formula is electrical, law of electrical neutrality is Nd plus P equals to Na plus N. For intrinsic semiconductor, are you adding any impurities? Intrinsic means pure. We are not adding any impurities. Therefore, acceptor impurities equals to donor impurities equals to zero. That means number of electrons is equals to number of holes. To indicate these are number of electrons in an intrinsic semiconductor, number of holes in intrinsic semiconductor, I is given. I means intrinsic. So in intrinsic semiconductor, number of electrons is equals to number of holes. That's proven. Okay. Now, for n-type semiconductor, and how, when you are going to get n-type semiconductor, if you add phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, what are those impurities are called? Donor impurities. That means acceptor impurities are zero. Then the above equation becomes Nd plus P is approximately equals to N, not approximately, exactly equals to N. Now it's an entire semiconductor. Its I is given intrinsic, so we are indicating NN. This N indicates n-type semiconductor. Hole concentration in n-type semiconductor, electron concentration in n-type semiconductor. In n-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers are electrons. Holes are small, negligible. Therefore, NN equals to, approximately equals to ND. One of the important for problems point of view, this one. NN equals to ND, that is, electron concentration in n-type semiconductor is approximately equals to ND. Then there is a... Now in n-type semiconductor, electron concentration equals to this much. If you want hole concentration, you want the value. We are neglected, but if you want that value, how to find out? There is a one law known as mass action law. What is that one says? N into P equals to Ni square. Electron concentration into hole concentration is equals to intrinsic concentration. Electron concentration into hole concentration is equals to intrinsic concentration. It is applicable for intrinsic as well as N-type semiconductor as well as P-type semiconductor. So for an n-type semiconductor, this is Nn Pn is equals to Ni square. What do you require? We require Pn value. Pn is equals to Ni square by Nn. What is this one? Ni square by Nn is nothing but Nd. This is another formula. So electron concentration in n-type semiconductor is approximately equals to Nd. Hole concentration is approximately equals to this formula. Similarly, for p-type semiconductor, Nd donor impurities are equals to 0. Therefore, that formula Na plus N is equals to Nd plus P. Nd is 0. Now, to differentiate, this is a p-type semiconductor, we are adding PP. For a p-type semiconductor, Np equals to approximately equals to negligible, 0, negligible. Therefore, this becomes Pp is approximately equals to Na. This is one more formula. Then this mass action law is applicable for p-type semiconductor also. That is, NpPp equals to Ni square. What is Pp? Na. Np is equals to Ni square. Therefore, N suffix P. We are approximately negligible. If you want exact value, this is the formula. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 formulas. And this is the sixth one. All these formulas are very, very, very important. Clear? Next. Next topic, diffusion length. L. diffusion length L. Now, electron, already I said initially, electron hole pair is generated, let us suppose there is some atoms like this. I have taken only simplicity, it's continuous one, okay. There is a 1, 4, covalent bonds are they existed are not represented. Let us suppose one of the covalent bond is broken, so electron hole pair is generated. Let us suppose this electron hole pair is generated. Now always these free electrons are randomly moving. It's here it comes, here automatically, here positive charge, here negative charge, will it attract with each other? So recombine. This free electron and hole will disappear, it becomes a valence electron. That means this electron, valence electron is generated, becomes free electron here. It's traveled to this much distance. This length is called diffusion length. The distance traveled by the free electron before recombination. The distance traveled by the free electron before recombination is called diffusion length. It is diffusion length for hole, diffusion length for electrons, LP, LN. The next one is carrier lifetime, tau. Carrier lifetime, tau. Now this valence electron became a free electron and it's traveled to this much, its recombination taken place here, they disappear. The time that free electron hole or free electron is live, how much time that electron is live, that's generated at this instant of time, recombined after certain time, how much gap it is existed, that is called carrier lifetime. The time that's generated to the recombination, how much gap, that is called carrier lifetime. It is denoted by tau p and tau n. The relationship between this lp and tau p is equals to L equals to square root of D into tau. That is LP equals to square root of DP into tau P. Similarly, LN equals to square root of DN into tau N. Clear? Go for a small topics that are there that we'll see after seeing some problems. Okay. Now, first problem. Pure germanium crystal has intrinsic concentration of, pure germanium crystal has an intrinsic concentration of 2.5 into 10 power 13, 2.5 into 10 power 13 per cubic centimeter, per cubic centimeter. That is, it's given it as 2.5 into 10 power 13 per cube centimeter, and it is given it as intrinsic concentration, and he mentioned at room temperature. At room temperature means it is 27 degrees centigrade, therefore it's equals to 300 degree Kelvin. If mobility of electron 3800 centimeter square per volt second, and mobility of hole 1800 centimeter square per volt second, then calculate resistivity, then calculate current density for electric field of 20 volts per centimeter is applied. Calculate the current density if an electric field of 20 volts per centimeter is applied. One of the units for electric field is volts per centimeter. That's important, all these things. Is clear? Now what do you ask to calculate? Rho. We directly, there is no formula for rho from this one, but there is a rho equals to 1 by sigma. Sigma is conductivity. What is sigma? N mu n e plus p mu p e. So n, now here it is given it as n I e. That means intrinsic concentration. In intrinsic semiconductor, number of electrons is equal to number of holes. That means this is Ni mu n e plus, this also nothing but Ni. Number of electrons is equal to number of holes. Ni mu p e. So it's Ni e, if you take it outside, mu n plus mu p. Before going to solve the problems in EDC, make sure that units are same, dimensions are same or not. That means all are in the same. Here centimeter cube, here centimeter square, here centimeter. Yes, no problem. If one is in centimeter, another one is in meters, convert into suitable formats. Here just check it, because in most of the EDC problems, these units also plays an important role. Dimensions also plays an important role. Just check it, centimeter cube, centimeter square, centimeter. Therefore, the final result also will be in centimeters. Okay. Now, so this Ni, 2.5 into 10 power 13, 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb, mu n plus mu p, 1800 plus, 3800 plus 1800. Okay, it's 4656. Therefore, you will get sigma. Once you know sigma, rho equals to 1 by sigma. It's ohm centimeter units. So, conductivity units are siemens per centimeter or mho per centimeter. Next, you ask to calculate J. What is the formula for J? It's Ohm's law, I said. J equals to sigma into E. This sigma is calculated, substitute here, E is given 20 volts per centimeter, you get current density. What are the units for current density? What is the formula for current density? It's I by A. What is I units? Amperes per area. Its dimensions are centimeters, so units are ampere per centimeter square. Ampere per centimeter square. So first calculate the sigma using this formula. Once you know sigma, you can calculate rho. Once rho is there, then J equals to sigma into E. Clear? First of all. Next problem. A pure silicon cylindrical wire, a pure silicon cylindrical wire of length 10 meters and cross sectional area 10 power minus 2 centimeter square. 10 power minus 2 centimeter square has an intrinsic concentration of 1.5 into 10 power 10 per centimeter cube. If an electric field of 50 volts per centimeter is applied, then calculate resistance of the wire and also current through the wire. Find resistance through the wire, okay, and also current through the wire. Now here important one, here it's given it as meters, all are in centimeters, convert it into centimeters. So convert this into centimeters, the first point. So then you ask to find out R and I. What is the formula for R? Rho L by A. Rho L by A. We have to calculate rho. L is given, A is given, rho. What is rho? 1 by sigma. That is sigma equals to n mu n e plus p mu p e. It's n is given, n I mu n e plus p. P I p is nothing but once again it is n I mu p e. So substitute this one, you will get sigma. Once you got sigma, you will get the rho, this thing. Okay, then you are going to get rho. But the problem is, whether he is given mu n and mu p, it's not given. Okay, it's not given. But that's why in the previous problem mu n and mu p are given. In this problem mu n and mu p are not given. If mu n and mu p are not given, but in the problem he given it is a silicon. For a silicon, mu n and mu p are given in the previous table, I gave it. Use those standard values because he mentioned at room temperature. At room temperature, use the standard values whatever I gave it in the previous table. Okay? That's why I said some problems the values will be given, some problems the values will not be given. If values are not given, you have to take the standard values. In the previous problem, standard values are given. In this problem, values are not given. Therefore, standard values take it. So, take down mu n, mu p for silicon. Calculate conductivity. Once conductivity, resistivity. Resistivity, then R. Clear? And this you can able to calculate R. First, convert the meters into centimeters. That's important point. Once you got it, then I. For that purpose, J equals to I by A. Therefore, I equals to J into A. What is J? Sigma into E, Ohm's law into A. Sigma calculated. E given. A given. So, you can able to calculate I. Units are amperes. Now you can able to calculate the IS. Next one. A silicon sample is third problem. A silicon sample is uniformly doped with donor type impurities with a concentration of 10^16 atoms per centimeter cube, and be given it as a donor type impurities. Take it as ND. Donor type impurities. Next, the electron and hole mobilities in the sample are electron and hole mobilities. Electron mobility mu n equals to 1200 centimeter square per volt second. Units are important. One of the gate question, units for mobility is dash. It's not once, twice are asked. New B, mobility of hole, 400 centimeter square per volt second. He is given mobility of electron and hole, therefore no need of going for standard values. Then, assume that, okay, respectively, mobility of electron and mobility of hole respectively given. Assume complete ionization of impurities taken place. Assume complete ionization of impurities taken place. Next, the charge of an electron is, the charge of an electron is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. Then calculate the resistivity. Calculate the resistivity of the sample. Calculate the resistivity of the sample. Now, it is given mu and mu p, charge of electron also given. So no need of biotting anything in this case. No need of remembering anything, because in this problem all the data are given. So that's why I already said some of the problems data will be given, some of the things is not given. Depending on the problem, you have to take it carefully. Clear? Now, we have to calculate rho. What is rho? 1 by, once again, same, most of the problems, very few in the same formulas are repeatedly changing with slight modification. So once you know the conductivity, you can able to calculate rho. So what is conductivity? N mu n e plus P mu P E. What is N? Electron concentration, mobility of electron, okay, this thing. Now, whether N and P are given in the previous first two problems, it's given intrinsic semiconductor. In intrinsic semiconductor, number of electrons is equal to number of holes. Therefore, this N and P are replaced by Ni, Pi, it's given. But in this problem, Ni is not given. It's given ND. It's given ND. That means these number of donor impurities are added. It's not an intrinsic semiconductor now. Donor impurities are added means it's an N-type semiconductor. In N-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers are electrons, minority charge carriers are holes. Can I neglect this one? Because the number is very small. This is very large. So in comparison to this value, this is negligible. So for an N-type semiconductor, sorry, since donor type impurities are added, it becomes an N-type semiconductor. In N-type semiconductor, holes are negligible. Therefore, this term itself negligible. Therefore, sigma N is equals to N mu N E. What is N? This is NN, N-type semiconductor. NN in the law of electrical neutrality, law of electrical neutrality, NN is replaced by ND, ND mu N E. ND is given 10 power 16 atoms per centimeter cube. Mu N, 1200 centimeter square per volt second, 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. Therefore, sigma N will becomes rho equals to 1 by sigma. Directly you are going to get it. Here important thing is simplification of the given conduct, this formula. Clear? Next problem. I think answer you are going to get it as here, rho equals to 0.52 ohm centimeter. 0.52 ohm centimeter. Next. Next problem. A piece of silicon is doped with phosphorus with a doping concentration of 10 power 16 atoms per centimeter cube. Phosphorus atoms. Phosphorus atoms means donor impurities or acceptor impurities? Donor impurities, ND. Okay? It's given ND. The expected value of mobility, the expected value of mobility with respect to doping concentration, with respect to doping concentration for silicon, assuming full dopant ionization is shown in below figure. The charge of electron 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. Then the conductivity of the silicon at room temperature is how much? The conductivity of silicon at room temperature is equals to how much? This is the thing. Clear? Now the given figure, it's doping concentration, doping concentration on x-axis, mobility mu on y-axis. The curve is like this. It starts with 1400, 1200, 1000, 800, 600, 400, 200, 0. Now 0, here 1 dot E plus 20, okay, like this. Now this is the given figure. You ask to find, calculate conductivity. Once again, conductivity formula is N mu N E plus P mu P E. He is given phosphorus impurities. Phosphorus impurities means donor. So this is negligible. It's an n-type semiconductor. N-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers are electrons, minority charge carriers are holes. Therefore, this term is negligible. Therefore, this becomes sigma n equals to nn plus mu n plus e. Nn is nothing but nd, mu n is nothing but e sigma n. Nd is given, mu is given in the problem itself. But this one, we cannot use standard value. See, listen, since mu n is not given, therefore you will use standard value. For that purpose, he given figure. See, he mentioned that the expected value of mobility versus doping concentration for silicon is given, assuming full ionization is given below. That means he is given mobility versus doping concentration. From this figure, you have to calculate the mobility, not the standard value. How to calculate that one? For that purpose, what is the doping concentration? It's the doping concentration. Doping concentration is 10 power 16. So for 10 power 16, what is the mobility? It's changing with respect to doping concentration. What is doping? It's 1 dot E plus 10 power 16. That is 1 into 10 power 16. E means exponential. 1 into 10 power 16. 1 into 10 power 16, it's here, it's nothing but 1200. So mobility is, in the from the figure, mobility is 1200 centimeter square per volt second. That's units are given here. centimeter square per volt second. So from the figure, if you go for the printed exactly, it's extending here, you will get 1200. So this mu n is 1200, nd is given, e is given, therefore direct substitution. Okay, the only thing is in this problem mu n is asked to calculate from this one, but the same formula. So till now whatever we are doing, all our gate problems and all our similar problems, each and every year there is a 1 mark question or 2 marks question compulsory from this formula. Maximum conductivity, resistivity. If you go through all the previous problems, previous gate question, compulsory problem. Okay, next one. A silicon bar is doped with donor impurities. A silicon bar is doped with donor impurities. Nd equals to 2.25 into 10 power 15 atoms per centimeter cube. Intrinsic concentration Ni equals to 1.5 into 10 power 10 atoms per centimeter cube. He is given Nd and he is given Ni. Temperature is equals to 300 degree Kelvin. Then find electron concentration. Then find electron concentration and hole concentration. Now, he is given donor impurities are added. Donor impurities are added means it becomes these many number of intrinsic 1.5 into 10, these many number of intrinsic impurities, these many number of donor impurities. Now donor impurities are added, therefore the semiconductor becomes an n-type semiconductor. Okay, an n-type semiconductor. For an n-type semiconductor, electron concentration is equals to Nd. Hole concentration is equals to Ni square by, that is Nn into Pn equals to Ni square, Pn equals to Ni square by Nn, that is Ni square by Nd. Okay. Nn is nothing but Nd equals to that one. So electron concentration is equals to this one. Hole concentration in n-type semiconductor equals to Ni. This whole square divided by 2.25 into 10 power 15. We will get the electron hole concentration in n-type semiconductor. Clear? This law of electrical neutrality is very, very, very important. Whatever the final obtained results are, very, very, very important one. Next one. Next problem, the charge of an electron is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. The KT by Q is equals to 25 millivolts. Mobility of electrons 1000 centimeter square per volt second. If the concentration gradient of electrons injected into p-type silicon sample is, that is dn by dx, it's given concentration gradient of electrons 1 into 10 power 21 per centimeter whole power 4. Then the magnitude of current density, the magnitude of current density J equals to how much? The magnitude of current density J equals to how much? Now, this is given, dN by dx is given. He asked to find out J. So, its current density due to electrons. The formula is E dN dN by dx. E is given. dN by dx is given. This value is not given. You have to calculate it. How to calculate it? It's a constant, don't take it like that, okay? Don't take the standard value. Here, there is one formula we gave, Einstein relationship. dP by mu p equals to dN by mu n equals to VT. VT is nothing but KT by Q. It's given 25 millivolts, but right now we require, this is not required. So dN equals to VT into mu n. VT 25 into 10 power minus 3, mu n, mobility 1000. So dN, you will obtain some value. Once you obtain dN, substitute here, you will get JN. Is it clear? We are going to get J. So here it's a diffusion. All the previous problems are based on drift. This problem is based on diffusion. It's clear? Next problem. Consider a silicon sample is doped with donor impurities of 10 power 15 atoms per centimeter cube. 10 power 15 atoms per centimeter cube. And intrinsic concentration of 1.5 into 10 power 10 atoms per centimeter cube. Intrinsic concentration of 1.5 into 10 power 10 atoms per centimeter cube. Till that one, okay, what's next continuation? If the sample is additionally doped with acceptor impurities of 1 into 10 power 18 atoms per centimeter cube. Additionally doped with acceptor impurities of 1 into 10 power 18 atoms per centimeter cube. Then approximately number of electrons is equals to how much? Number of holes is equals to how much? At room temperature. At room temperature. And previous problems, most of the problems he is given only donor impurities. Now in this problem he is given donor impurities as well as acceptor impurities. In that case, okay, now first of all we have to identify whether it acts as an n-type semiconductor or p-type semiconductor. Na is greater than Nd. Therefore it acts as a p-type semiconductor. So p-type semiconductor, number of holes is equals to acceptor impurities. It's not Na, okay, it's now Na minus Nd. Some of the donor impurities, some of the acceptor impurities will combine, so it is n 10 power 18 minus 10 power 15, this is equals to 10 power 3. So number of holes equals to 10 power 3. Number of electrons is equals to ni square by pp. So ni square is given pp. What is pp? 10 power 3. Therefore, now it's not any, don't assume it as a p-type semiconductor. Out of 10 power 18, 10 power 15 decombination taken place. So left over is only 10 power 3. Okay. Therefore, number of holes in p-type semiconductor is only 10 power 3. Number of electrons is equals to using this formula. Clear? Therefore, whatever the thing, you just substitute it, simplify it. Next. Now we'll take the questions. It's Avani from Jaipur. Sir, what is intrinsic concentration? Intrinsic concentration is denoted as Ni. In intrinsic semiconductor, number of electrons is equals to number of holes. So, number of electrons into number of holes is equals to total concentration for an intrinsic semiconductor. For an intrinsic semiconductor, total concentration equals to electron concentration into hole concentration. That is NiPi. But intrinsic semiconductor, electrons equals to holes, Ni square. That means Ni square equals to Ni into Pi. Total concentration is equal, intrinsic concentration means number of electrons in intrinsic semiconductor into number of holes in intrinsic semiconductor. Number of electrons is equals to number of holes, therefore it's nothing but Ni square. Clear, Avani? Arnaba Lahari, please explain how hole can have diffusion length. Now see here. Here let us suppose hole, here electron. Okay. Now there is assume that, yeah, no, in the same thing, yeah. After this, what is going to happen after certain time? There is a strong tendency that it comes like this. So what is the meaning of this thing? Hole comes here. So now hole comes here means electron has to go this. That means this is traveled this much distance or not? Or this much distance or this much, it's a smaller value. Clear? It's moving or not? This is called diffusion length of hole. How much distance is traveled before recombination? Now it's moving, okay? Electron hole pair is, hole is there, here electron is there. It's moving. Next it moves to here hole. But there is a, some free electron comes here, recombines. So what is going to happen? Hole disappear or not? From initially hole is here, it traveled this much distance. This is called diffusion length. This is called diffusion length before recombination. There is one more free electron comes from some neighboring atom, its recombination takes place, therefore hole disappear. How much distance traveled before the recombination? It's clear? This is called diffusion length for the hole. Okay. We complete this session today. We'll continue with the problems tomorrow, then we'll go for the next topics. Thank you.